green dream room show.
It's a very green episode this week, as Hannah just mentioned, because we are going to be celebrating how unique Kiwis really are. Our first story will be on the green group's first garden, and then we'll celebrate the top 10 reasons why Kiwis rule. So first up, let's have some Kiwi goodness with the Kiwi notices. Enjoy.
Notices for Friday the 7th of November. Milo girls trialling for Dunedin schoolgirl team. Don't forget about trials Sunday 10 a.m. at Bayfield. It will be in the Edgar Centre if raining. Guard costume fitting after interval today in hall. If you have your coat hanger, can you bring it to Miss Cooper? Tickets are on sale for the show. $5 adults, $2 primary and intermediate children. Don't miss out. First in, first served. Order from office if you want, you won't be seeing it at school. Could all people who brought plants along for the green group garden please come to the garden at 12:30? Sorry, we had no meeting. There will be one on Wednesday next week. Thanks heaps. Staff notices. Please give a copy of your class cover sheet to Mr. Hunter for the ASTL Level 2 and 3, Level 3 and 4, Reading and Maths. The one that compares to national norms A by WED. Year 8 stuff, please send to me ASAP. Your class list and web suits needed and names of your parent helpers so I can complete the paperwork for Mr. Hunter. Oh, one late notice to hand. No water polo practice on Sunday night, Thursday morning at 7:30 a.m. Meet Miss Q at the old dive pool. All players.
Good that you're back, because I think it's time for our top 5 fabulous Kiwi faves.
Ooh.
And number 1 is the most fabulous, the most amazing, none other than the gumboot.
Ah, the gumboot, yes. One of New Zealand's traditional footwear, except for, you know, the jandal. And gumboots are worn on farms, I think.
Yeah, most of the time. And but they also come in like girly fashions, you know, like pink ones with like little love hearts and, you know, girly ones like that. But if you do see a grown-up man, very muscly, on a farm wearing some pink gumboots with red love hearts, my suggestion, be afraid.
Run. Our second fave is the pavlova.
The very delicious New Zealand treat. I love it, you know, it's nice and fluffy, with the nice cream on the top, and little bits of kiwi.
Stop it, you're making me hungry.
Sorry.
You will be.
Jeez.
Just jokes.
Next we have our fresh summer fruits. The strawberries, the kiwi fruits, and the watermelon.
That sounds so good. Our fourth favourite is the barbecue.
Oh, I love barbecues. And our fifth favourite is the beach, the perfect place to go on a hot summer's day.
You know, we may not be at the beach right now, but let's have a look at the birthdays.
Sounds great.
Birthdays for next week are Hayden Clearcorn, Liam Driver, Libby Ockwell, Kieran McLaren, Julian Brown, Kerry Cameron, Rory Jackson, Michaela Shittleborough, Sarah Whitmore, Michael Gray, Andrew Goodwin, and Harriet George. Happy birthday.
While we're on the subject of green things, I think it's time to check out the green group story.
Yeah.
We're here with Sammy Weston and my last name.
Here we go.
Yeah. I knew it, I just forgot it. Like, thanks. Yeah. Okay. They've kind of, them and a lot of their friends have created up the green group. And what is the green group?
It's a group of like people, and we're like making the school more environmental, and we're making a garden, as you can see over there. And yeah.
So, what's your favourite thing that you're growing at the Green Group garden?
I'm not sure. It's just I quite like strawberries. Yeah, in time.
Yeah. Are you gonna like make chocolate and like have like different chocolate?
That would be good.
Yeah. Yeah. Plan for the future.
Yeah.
No, I
checked
my
cheeks.
I'll read it.
I reckon it looks pretty cool. Here are Nick's two favourite signs. Picnic at the Gardens. And of course, our seventh one is a nice family game of cricket.
Do you know what else is the Kiwi thing?
What?
No, not like a favourite thing or anything.
What?
The sports news.
Oh, good point. Not exactly a favourite, but let's check out Zach's sports news.
Welcome to this week's sports news. I'm here with Chris and Josh. They went to the North Zones on Tuesday. What events did you and how did you go, Chris?
In the 800, I came first. In shot put, I came fourth. And in discus, I came first. In the sprints, I made the final.
And Josh, how did you go?
I came first in the hurdles.
made it through the tuggers and high jump, and our relay team made it through the tuggers.
And our relay team won as well. Yeah, and next up I had an interview with Mary. Now I'm here with Mary. What events did you do and how'd you go?
Well, in 800 metre I came first. It was a really close race. And in relays we came, our team came first, which was really good. And in long jump I came second and I got into high jump.
Congratulations. And that is this week's sports news.
So next we have a story.
Now we've already had that.
Hannah, we have two stories today.
Ah, I knew that. Let's have a look at the Norm Hewitt story.
This Monday being it from Norm Hewitt and Shelley, who are part of the SPCA program One of the Family. They focus on teaching kids and young adults that human and animals are the same, and violence towards human and animals is wrong and should never happen. Norm Hewitt was really entertaining and we enjoyed the stories he told us. Just a reminder, we are holding a food drive for the SPCA and we only have 4 cans of cat food, 2 boxes of cat biscuits, a singles pouch of cat food, and a frisbee for a dog. All the food is for cats. We need to think about the dogs too. Thank you for everyone who's donated something yet, but remember we have a couple of weeks left, so keep on donating. Up next, we have an ad for our movie makers group. This movie this year is called Stranded, produced by our own Harriet George. Carl will be doing a movie review on it next week, so make sure you catch that. Here's their latest ad.
Coming to a picnic. A story of adventure, fear, and excitement.
Oh my gosh.
Harriet George production of Stranded.
Mrs. Medley and her sister find a baby dinosaur when they're out walking one day. They have no idea the impact it will have on a field trip many years later. As the ship hit rocks, a few survivors swim to a deserted island. They have no idea that they are not the only living things on the island.
That's all for this week. Come back next week, same time, same place. Hannah is not able to finish this episode because of production practice. But we will have some highlights of the show next week. It's going to be a great show, so make sure you get your tickets from the office. $5 for adults and $2 for kids. This will be the only chance for you to see it, because they will not be performing it for us. If there's something to film, we'll be there.
We have a story now.
Oh, no, I'm not. Welcome to Retail TV!
You say your red light, I'm going to take it on. Welcome to this week's sports news. I'm here with Chris and Josh from the Northland Sports.
No,
not from. Hey, welcome to this week's sports news. I'm here with Chris and Josh from the Northland Sports.
No,
not from. Hey, week two. I'm now here with Mary. What events did you do and how'd you go?
Well, in 800 metre I came first, and now
Notices for Friday the... What's the date today?
7th.
Okay, 7th. Notices for Friday the 7th.